Hey everyone, welcome to our first interpolation topic of this numerical methods course. And in this video, we will be understanding what Lagrange polynomials are. So, in this video, we will be talking about what they are, what we use them for, and we'll talk about some of the theory behind them. Let's begin with what a Lagrange polynomial is. Well, they are simply polynomials that we use to find functions. To give you a visual, let's imagine that we are heating a bucket of water on a stove, and we are given the following discrete data points for the temperature of the water over time. Well, what if we want to turn these discrete data points into a function that can tell us the water's temperature at any point between times 0 and 10? For example, let's say that we wanted to find the water's temperature at time 2.5. Well, without knowing our interpolating function here, we can't say for sure what that value is. This is where interpolation comes in. We can find functions that fit our data points and allow us to find previously unknown intermediate values through using continuous functions. In summary, Lagrange polynomials are just one of the simpler interpolation techniques that we can use to find functions between known data points. I'm just going to write the formula for Lagrange polynomials here. This formula can look a bit daunting at first, however, when we break it down, it becomes much less confusing and actually makes a lot of sense. Firstly, if you are unsure, the large sigma symbol here is used for summation notation, and it tells us that for each iteration of j up to n, we add a new term. And within each j iteration, we fill out that term with this large capital pi, which denotes product notation, meaning for every iteration, we will have a new item, and we track that with the iteration counter k. I recognize that this may still be confusing. So let's say that we have the following three data points for our previous bucket example, for which we need to find the function of time for. Well, we have three data points, therefore n equals 3. And this means that we will have a second degree Lagrange polynomial, as we always have n minus 1 as our degree of the Lagrange polynomial, which means that we will have three terms as our j term tells us here. We begin with our first term, which is when j is equal to 1. Let's begin with our y1 term, and because we are currently on j equals 1, we will not have any x1 values in this first term. Since in our product notation, we are told to exclude if k is equal to j, as this would lead to all terms going to 0, which I'll explain here in a minute. So we begin with this term when k equals 2, as it cannot equal 1. So we have our input variable x minus x2 over xj, which is x1 in this case, minus xk, which is x2, and because this is product notation, we multiply our next iterations until we reach n, which is 3 for this example. Therefore, through the same logic, we have the following, and this is all we need to do for our first term. Now we will create our new term as a summation term tells us, and we can just go ahead and complete the remaining terms using the same logic as before. Now, that is all we need to do other than plugging in our variables and simplifying. Previously I mentioned that it makes sense that we leave out k equals j, but why is that? Well, as interpolation functions need to go through all the data points that we give it, what would happen to this function if we gave it an input of x1 and we have x minus x1 present? Well, you can see that no matter what, terms 2 and 3 go to 0, as x1 minus x1 gives 0. Well, then we are just left with this first term. X1 minus X1 will again give us 0, whereas we know the answer should be Y1. And this is why we remove the terms where K equals J. Now, the cool thing with Lagrange polynomials is that up until this part of our problem will be the same if you are interpolating for any problem with three data points. Then you would just go ahead and plug in your discrete data points for all the variables and simplify the function. In the coming videos, we will be completing several Lagrange interpolation examples, so stay tuned for those if you're still confused. I hope that this video helped your understanding of Lagrange polynomials, If you enjoyed, please like, subscribe, and consider checking out our YouTube memberships by clicking that join button down below. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below, and I will do my best to address your concerns.